Sodom and Gomorrah. When I speak those two words, I'm sure in your mind you have images of fire and brimstone raining down from heaven, burning up all of the homosexual predators. That's the way it's been painted to us. That's the way we've seen it on TV. That's the way we've heard it preached from the pulpit. But I would encourage you right now to open up your Bible to Genesis chapter 19. Read it yourself from beginning to end. Turn this back on and let's talk about it. Let's get into it and see what it really has to say. First of all, before the tale begins, the Bible says that the two angels that went to Sodom and Gomorrah, to Sodom specifically, had come to Abraham ahead of time, and they had informed him of their plans. He knew they were coming to destroy the city. So it wasn't this act that happened at Lot's house that caused them to say, "That's it, we're burning you up." They were already on their way to do it. And in fact, Abraham pleaded with them, "Oh, you know, if you can even find 10 righteous people in this city, will you relent? Will you not burn it up, please?" And they couldn't even find 10. Now remember, in the Bible, righteousness does not come by works. It has nothing to do with how good we are, what works that we do. Righteousness is always by faith. Faith in the one true living God. There were not even 10 people in this city who believed in the one true living God. They were idol worshipers, and I'm going to show you how this works. So in verse 4, it says, "The men of the city, even the men of Sodom, they compassed the house round, both old and young, and the people from every quarter." And one of the versions leaves out that little ending part, "the people from every quarter," because it almost sounds redundant. The first word, "man," the men from Sodom, came around the house. That word is enosh. And that word in Hebrew can definitely mean a group of males, specifically. So if that's all the verse said, we can make the argument that, oh, a bunch of male homosexuals came pounding on Lot's door to try to have sex with these angels who were inside. But the verse goes on to say, both young and old, all the people from every quarter. That word for people really does mean just that. It's the word Hebrew, the Hebrew word am, and that means tribe, nation, group of peoples, and it always includes females. So we've got this whole town there, not just a select group of males that are trying to pound the doors down. Now, let's talk about the image we have in our mind. We've been taught that it's a group of homosexuals, and as the translators of the NIV write, they knock on the door, "We want to have sex with those beautiful angels that have just come in. We want to have sex with them." That sounds so genteel. Was it really? If you're trying to have sex with people, you know, orgiastic or whatnot, are you pounding down the doors to break it? Because if you read here in verse 9, it says that they are pounding on the doors so hard that they're trying to break them down. Now, I'm sorry, but a bunch of gay men having a good time, they're not pounding down someone's door that's not interested in having sex with them. They're not trying to break in. So obviously this is not about party time. It's not about consensual or even orgiastic sex necessarily. It's about brutal, violent, humiliating, dominating sex. It is about gang rape. Let's continue to talk about this. In the ancient times, this was a common practice. Strangers that came into your town, just to show who was boss, they would often rape them. Peoples who were vanquished, who were conquered by other nations, they were often raped, men, women alike, by the conquerors, just to show them who was boss. Right? And even today, it still happens. Don't we all know and understand that in prison, inmates suffer rape, brutal rape? Because the perpetrator is a homosexual who just wants to have sex? Absolutely not. The men who perpetrate this are heterosexual, but they're into domination. They're into showing people who's boss. They're brutal. They're violent. And it's a horrible, horrible situation. This is what the story of Sodom and Gomorrah is about. It is not about loving same-sex connections that are monogamous and faithful, mutual, consensual. It's about gang rape. Now stay tuned for part 2, where I'm going to show you some more Hebrew words from this story, and I am going to reveal translator bias.